This is the Louie Tee Network.
Welcome to another edition of the Draft Prospects 101 series, your guide to some of the biggest and hottest names of the 2017 NFL Draft. We're talking quarterbacks right now on the series. We've already knocked down Mitchell Trubisky. Mama named him Mitchell. I'm going to call him Mitchell. Another guy that I feel like is at the top of this class, and I think there are three guys really that you look at it as potential first rounders. Maybe a fourth can sneak into that conversation. We'll talk about him a little bit later on in the process. But this is a guy that I'm very familiar with, being a Notre Dame Fighting Irish fan myself. I can tell you some of his strengths, a lot of his weaknesses, and some of the things that I've grown accustomed to seeing him do on the football field. And there are going to be some things he's going to have to clean up. There are going to be some things that he's going to do extremely well right away. But make no mistake about it, like I've mentioned with the other quarterbacks and will continue to mention throughout this process, none of these guys are ready to start day one at the next level. And I don't think this guy is any different. I'm talking about Notre Dame's DeShone Kizer. A lot of potential, a lot of talent. This guy can get it done, I think, if given time. And much like I said with Mitchell Trubisky, if put in the right situation with the right coaching staff that's willing to work with this guy, you could have yourself a potential starting NFL quarterback in as early as 2 years from now. So let's talk about DeShone Kizer and what he brings to the table. And this is a young man that I feel like can do a lot of things on the football field. It's underrated for some of the things that he can do. Some of his things are traits that stand out from the rest. And then there's some things that he's going to have to work on, much like every other player entering the 2017 NFL Draft. Let's start with DeShone Kizer and his pros. So you start with DeShone Kizer's pros, and the first thing that I look at with DeShone Kizer is his size at 6'4", 230 pounds. It doesn't get much better than that, folks. That's the, right there, that's the size you're looking for, okay? 6'5 is great. 6'5 a lot of times limits your mobility, however. 6'4 is right in that wheelhouse where you're perfectly symmetrical, if you will. 230 pounds, big, solid frame, sturdy, tough to bring down. He has everything in terms of size. You look at him, he looks the part of an NFL quarterback. So I think that's a big plus for DeShone Kizer. Tremendous arm. One of the biggest arms in this draft, if you're talking just natural throw of the football. I think the strongest arm in this draft is going to go to Patrick Mahomes II. But DeShone Kizer, not very far behind. This young man can fling it with the best of them. So, of course, three-level arm, can make all the throws, deep, intermediate, and short. And so that's something that I think a lot of scouts are salivating over. You put the size with the arm talent, and those are things that sometimes you don't get in the same package. DeShone Kizer offers both of them to you. He's got some accuracy. Now, I think sometimes he can be inaccurate, and I don't think he's as accurate as a Mitch Trubisky. And I think we saw a little bit of that at the combine. You saw a little bit of that in the 2016 season. There were times where DeShone Kizer wasn't as accurate as advertised, but he can be very accurate with the football. I've seen him carve teams up, be extremely efficient with the football. And so I think he's accurate in and outside of the pocket. You want to see him throw the football extremely well. Go watch the very first game of 2016 versus Texas. You want to watch him throw the football very well. Go watch him against Syracuse in 2016. You want to watch him throw the football very well. Go watch him in 2015, where I thought he had some amazing games and led the Irish to an 11-3 record. So this is a guy that he can throw the football and he can be extremely accurate when protected. DeShone Kizer can be just as accurate as anyone in this draft class. Throwing motion. I think that's something that a lot of scouts and evaluators are also salivating over is that his throwing motion is quick, it's compact, it's fluid, it's not elongated. Teams love big guys that can throw it a long ways, that doesn't take a long time to do it. Byron Leftwich had a cannon, but it took him 18 years to get rid of the football because of that elongated motion. This is a guy in DeShone Kizer that has a compact throwing motion. The ball comes out of his hands extremely quick, and teams love that about him as well. Next pro, he's a good athlete. Now, he's not gonna run a 4.6 anything, not gonna run a 4.7 anything as you saw at the combine. That's not what he does, but what he is a guy that can move his feet, that can run on 3rd and 5 and get you 6. He is a guy that can extend the play with his legs, get out of the pocket, and still find a target 40 yards down the field outside of the pocket or 12 yards out of by the sidelines as he scrambles to extend the play. He is a good enough athlete to outrun a defensive end. He is a good enough athlete to be a threat in the red zone. I think he's more of an athlete than people give him credit for. I think he's a really solid athlete. Ran read option at Notre Dame. Wasn't as good at it as probably the quarterback behind him in Malik Zaire, but again, he was a guy that was athletic enough to keep defenses honest, and I think at the next level, he'll be able to do the same. Solid pocket poise and escapability. Another one of these guys that isn't afraid to stare down the gun barrel, which is the next pro, so I'll go ahead and lump those two in right now. Willing to stare down the gun barrel. Great poise in the pocket. Doesn't panic under duress. Will shift and move and have a little bit of mobility inside the pocket. But again, when things break down, can and will escape outside the pocket. Will look to run, but it's always eyes up looking down the field to see if he can deliver the football too. So has that escapability, not necessarily looking to run and escape to run, but also looking to still deliver the football. So I think he has that in his arsenal as well. Dual threat quarterback. I think you can go ahead in this day and age now in the National Football League, you look at these quarterbacks, and I think you don't run a ton of read option, but it's good to know that it's in your back pocket. Him having done that at the collegiate level, I think it's something that you throw in the playbook and have a couple of snaps for that. Tucked away when you need it, you bust it out and maybe able to get a nice gain off of it. So he has that ability. Again, this kind of goes with the athleticism that we mentioned a little bit earlier in this breakdown. And then toughness is another a pro for DeShone Kizer. I think he's a tough guy, very physical. Again, at 230 pounds and 6'4", he's physically built to be tough. I've seen him bounce off of defenders as if he's a pinball. And so this is a guy that is very big. I always remember how hard it was to sack Drew Bledsoe, how hard it's been throughout Ben Roethlisberger's career to sack him. This is a guy in that similar mold of a big, big-framed quarterback that it's hard to bring down. If you don't come with a hard hat and a lunch pail, he's not going to go down very easily because of how sturdy and solidly built he is, and he's not afraid to take on a defender. Again, 3rd and 4, he's not afraid to put his shoulder down to get 5. And so the toughness is definitely there with DeShone Kizer, and that also speaks to his ability to stare down the gun barrel and deliver the football, not afraid to take a shot in the pocket to deliver it down the field. But you go from his pros to some unfortunate cons. Let's jump into those. Much like a lot of these quarterbacks in this draft, just about all of them, he didn't play in a pro-style offense. I think one of the few that actually did was Nathan Peterman of Pitt. So he's comfortable under center and doing it, but DeShone Kizer is not. And so he's a guy you're going to have to work with, obviously, with those things. He did make reads, however, at Notre Dame under Brian Kelly. He did have to go through progressions. And so it's not like one of these first read, usually open, get him the football type of offenses. He actually did have a read progression-based offense, but it was out of the spread. And so it did make it a lot easier on him. And again, not under center, so 5-step drop, 5-step with the hitch, 7-step drops, all of these things are going to be foreign to him, as well as terminology and being in a playbook. Another one of these guys that look to the sideline to get plays. Again, I think they did actually have verbiage at Notre Dame, not one of these card-holding universities where you don't have any verbiage and you're absolutely lost at the next level. But again, I think having played in a spread offense for the duration of his career at Notre Dame, it's gonna hurt him at the next level, making that transition from college quarterback to pro-style NFL under center quarterback. Tries to do too much, especially in the fourth quarter, is the next con. And I think, to me, this is the biggest knock on him right now is I think there are situations where he's got to be aware. Situational awareness is key. In any sport, really, especially in football, situational awareness is key. You got to know down and distance, and you got to know what the situation calls for. I'll give you an example of him trying to do too much against Texas, first game of the season. There, it's tied at 37. Notre Dame's got an opportunity to win the game in regulation. They send a blitzer off the edge, unaccounted for. Kizer, I think, didn't really recognize what was going on early enough, but he's got one-on-one coverage down the sidelines with his receiver, who had been having a magnificent game. You throw it up to him. This guy's like 6'6". Throw it up to him, give him an opportunity. Kizer holds on to the ball, curls up into the fetal position, takes a sack, and Notre Dame is forced to punt the football, and the game goes into overtime. I'll give you another example of doing too much. He's the type of guy that will roll out of the pocket, extend a play, and then take a 14-yard sack. That's unnecessary. Against Stanford, down 7, 17-10, you got a situation where you're inside the red zone, no more timeouts, can't take a sack. What does he do? He tries to run the ball. Where are you going? You can't run in this situation. Situational football tells you no timeouts, less than 30 seconds in the game. You cannot, under any circumstances, run unless you're going to get the first down or you're going to get out of bounds. Neither of which was attainable. Throw the football away. It was second down, as a matter of fact. Live to fight another day. Instead, he goes and scrambles, gets hit in the field of play, which then causes him to have to spike the football, losing precious seconds and a down. Now it's fourth down with the game on the line. And guess what he does? Takes another sack. Again, situational awareness. Fourth down, game on the line. You can't win running the football from 17 yards away. At least throw it into the end zone and give your teammate a chance to make a play. Again, trying to do too much. That's a bad trait right now that I see in DeShone Kizer right now. And that's something he's going to have to clean up. You know, a pick six against USC, trying to do too much. A lot of the interceptions that he throws, trying to do too much. And I think that's something, especially in the fourth quarter. They had opportunities in Notre Dame this year to win games, and Kizer simply did not get it done. The aforementioned Stanford game, they had opportunities to win against Navy, against other teams, Texas, even though the defense was probably to blame in that Texas game. There are countless opportunities for this team to win games. Duke is another game that comes to mind where Kizer struggled late in the ball game and didn't give his team a chance. There were opportunities to win games. Kizer didn't get it done. Another con that scares me is that he was much better in 2015 than he was in 2016. You could argue the talent around him wasn't as great. You lose some players to the pro game. I understand that. But still, again, this goes back to trying to do too much. The defense was atrocious for Notre Dame in 2016 versus a really good defense in 2015. You lose a guy like Jalen Smith, the defense is bound to be worse. And they were. And because the defense wasn't good and you knew you had to score a ton of points to win, maybe he felt like he needed to put the burden and the onus on his shoulders. And he tried to do too much in 2016. Hence, a little bit more turnovers. Hence, not getting it done in crucial situations. 2015 tape for me with Kizer, much better than the 2016 tape, which is a problem for me as well. And then finally, the last con, is he a winner? At Notre Dame, his career record was 14-11. That's not a great record for a guy that started two seasons at a major college program. You'd like to see that record be much better than that. Like I said, in 2016, a lot of those losses piled up because remember, DeShone Kizer in 2015, 10-3. I think I said 11-3 earlier, 10-3 with the Fighting Irish in his inaugural starting season, where I thought he was phenomenal. I thought he did a lot of things that had a lot of Notre Dame Fighting Irish fans, including myself, excited about 2016, and it just turned out to be a really, really ordinary, average season for Kizer. It started out with a bang against Texas. He was phenomenal in that football game, but it really didn't have that build-up effect that we were looking for. He didn't get better. I thought he kind of flatlined in 2016. And so, is he a winner? Opportunities to win late in ball games, and he didn't get it done in 2016. And that kind of makes me a little nervous. So, there's some things Kizer has to work on, but if you're talking strictly potential and talent, I don't know if you're going to find a combination of the two. Size, measurables, arm talent, all of those things, quick release. You get it in this package in DeShone Kizer, and I think that's going to intrigue a team and have them make the decision of pulling the trigger on him in the first round in the 2017 NFL Draft. That's going to do it for DeShone Kizer and his 2017 NFL Draft Prospects 101 breakdown. If it happens in the National Football League, whether big or small, we cover it all here in the Lab Room on the Louie Tee Network. Come back and join me as I got plenty more breakdowns to come. More quarterbacks coming down the pipeline. I'll see you a little bit later on. Free agency is getting underway. We're going to do all of those things. Enjoy all of the content. I'll see you a little bit later on. Have a good one. Whether you're looking for more great content or more of me, your man, Louie Tee, follow, like, and subscribe to the following social media platforms of mine.